Hello, welcome to Harper Carroll AI. Today we are going to go through downloading large language models onto your local machine, so onto your laptop, so that you can run them without a GPU. And Ollama is a company that has created this app that makes it really easy to do this on your own device. And so they set everything up for you and they make it just really simplified. And so in order to do this today, we're going to start on ollama.com and let's just get it set up on our machine. So you want to go to ollama.com, click download. They have it for Mac OS, Linux, and Windows. So do that. I already have mine downloaded. So take a moment here to do that. Pause if you haven't done that. Once that is set up, we can go to Mistral. And if you want to download a different model, you can go to this models area. They have lots of models, and you can search the model that you want. But we're going to do Mistral. And so you want to run Ollama run Mistral. And so open a terminal. I usually use iTerm, but for the purposes of this guide, we will use a terminal. And so this is going to download. And once it's done, I will come back. Okay, so the model has finished loading. And so if I were to just type, what is the capital of MC? This model is open. And so Mistral is running now. And we can do Control C to stop. Oh, I guess it stopped anyway. And I can say, what is So when I say what does have one, because it has a context, as in because it has this history of chat, it can know what the one is referring to. But if I were to say, so let's look at the options. So slash question mark. And the questions are we can slash clear will clear the session context right here. So we can say, and we can also save your current session. That's kind of cool. So you could say, slash save and then hello. So let's say clear. And then now if I say what does have one, it won't have that context. So that is what a context is. And context lengths are the amount of tokens that the model can store in its brain. I mean memory. So in its current working memory. And so there is a context length for different models. Mistral has its own. I think it might be 32,000, but different models have longer context lengths, which means that they can store more in their memory. Although, do note that in models, as you get further and further away from the beginning of the context and the context length is longer, the memory tends to degrade. So, their ability to access earlier parts of their memory does tend to degrade. So, just be aware of that. If you're trying to, fit a whole book into a context and have it reference it perfectly, there might be some performance loss in that case. All right, so now we have Mistral here. And so again, in the future, if you want to run it, you say Ollama run Mistral, and we could download other models. Be aware of storage on your computer. If we could say slash buy. We could also say Ollama run Mistral and then say, let's look at the session variables. So these are the options, set parameter, word wrap. Let's look at the different parameters. So we have seed, num predict. So this is setting the seed is for when you want the runs to be the same. So remember, if you check out my Instagram, I talk about what seeds are. And basically, seeds are what allows consecutive runs or different runs of random events on different computers to be the same. So seeds determine the randomness. Randomness in computers are actually not random. It's pseudo random and it's based on the seed. So if you set the same seed and it's just an integer in two different numbers, and then you run the same process, which involves some stochasticity, which means that it involves some randomness or sampling of a variable from a distribution of variables, then it will output the same sample. Even though it should have been kind of a random sample from this distribution. So, for example, say you have just a simple distribution of 70% likely to be one and 30% likely to be zero. That's just two options. It would choose a random number, and then if it's like 70 or less, it would be 1, and 71 or more, it'd be 0, something like that, or maybe 69 or less. Anyway, it would choose that same number for both different computers if you set the same seed. So that allows, if you're training a model, for it to converge to the same weights, or any kind of random process will be the same in both computers. So if you want to set the seed, you can. And that would also cause the output of the models to be the same. So if you were to run, give it a prompt and set the seed, you would, and you were to give the same seed for two different models that are the same and give it a prompt, that output from the prompt would be the same in both of those computers. Because again, it's when it's outputting the text, it's sampling from a distribution for each word, for each token that is generated by the large language model. It is sampling from the distribution, the likelihood of different possible next words, choosing the word that it comes up with. And so if you set the seed, then it would just come up with the same word every time it samples. Num predict is the number of tokens to predict, so how many tokens to output in the response. Pick from the top k number of tokens, so you can narrow the window of how many tokens you are selecting from. So you could select from the full distribution of likelihood, or you could say, oh, just for the most likely three. I'm not sure what pick a token based on the sum of probabilities does. Repeat penalty is really good if you're finding that the model is repeating a lot. You could set the repeat penalty to 1.15 or even 1.3. Temperature is how much to kind of cause the model to have a greater distribution of words to sample. So it would make words that are potentially less likely to output next more likely. So it might act a little bit more erratic because it's giving more likelihood to words that it normally wouldn't. Stop parameters are like if it runs into a certain text phrase, then it will stop outputting. So this is good if you're kind of manually creating a chat where you want to say, like, if it goes back to question, then stop. Like sometimes people will run into issues where they say, like, question, answer, and then the model is outputting a new question and a new answer, and a new question. You can set a stop parameter so that if it sees the token question, then it stops. Okay, and then if we say bye, I want you to know where the models are. It's in this path. So this is where the models are. So if you ever need to, delete a model, you might need to delete these to clear some space on your machine. So, hi, I am Harper. Let's see what it says. Okay, so now let's say save. Okay, so then if I were to say clear, then I could say load. Great. So this is really cool that you can save chats, and it's kind of like ChatGPT, but it's all local on your machine. The only thing you need to be aware of is space on your computer and the RAM on your computer. But it looks like we can run these models locally, which is really cool. So you don't need a GPU to run it. And then I think you can fine-tune this. So in the future, let's go forward and fine-tune together. But for this week, just download it, try out different models. There are coding models here. There are a lot of models in different languages, like Aya has 23 languages. So try them out, comment below how it goes. I hope you enjoy it this week, and I'll check back with you all soon. Let me know what it is you want to work on going forward. But there are lots of really cool models here. So play around this week, and we'll check in next week. Take care. Bye.